Alright guys, now, I'm just decided, I'm going to do a little bit of shooting. But I want to talk about something that's quite important as well. Basically, whether or not you should incorporate a pause into your shot cycle. Now, it's quite important in as much as it depends on what kind of bow you're shooting and what kind of archery you're doing as to whether or not you should try and incorporate a pause into your shot cycle. Now, if you see, the problem is, I think, a lot of people watch top flight archers, and it looks to all intents and purposes like some of these guys incorporate a pause into their shot cycle, and actually they don't. But you've got to watch really, really carefully. Now with top flight archers, like Olympic green curve archers, people like that, it looks like they are pausing, it looks like there's a pause in their shot cycle, but there isn't. See, what they're actually doing is that they are continuously pulling and pulling and pulling. Towards the end of the shot of the cycle, it becomes an almost imperceptible movement until they reach the clicker. Now, a lot of the time, when they're watching my camera, the cameras are on that side, so they're watching this side of the bus, and they don't see the clicker in action. And basically, for those of you who don't know, I mean, most of you should, on this side of the bow, on the inside of the bow, there is a metal sprung blade which you put the arrow underneath the blade, and then when you draw it back, and when the arrow comes out from underneath the blade, it clicks as it drops onto the side of the bow, at which point the archer looses his arrow. Now some traditional archers have a psychological clicker, as in, as soon as they get to a certain point in their draw, whether it's coming back to here or whatever, as soon as their thumb or their finger or the string or whatever reaches that point there, they loose, because they know they're at full draw. But again, it depends on what kind of archery you're doing as well. For instance, if you're shooting an Olympic recurve or a modern traditional style bow which is made out of modern materials, you can pause if you want to, and then you can micro adjust your aim, the aim point, things like that, and it will do the bow no damage whatsoever. It will do your shot sequence no damage whatsoever. But the thing you've got to remember is you are shooting a bow which is made out of modern materials. And modern materials are extremely forgiving when it comes to holding and increasing the tension of the bow. Because what you're doing, when you draw a full draw, when you come to full draw, if you then stop, if your bow is made out of modern materials, you're actually storing energy, waiting for the release. But it doesn't try and follow the string. Modern bows can be left strung for weeks on end and they'll have no detrimental effect on the bow at all. It might stretch the string, but the bow itself will not suffer at all. So you can get away with having a pause in your shot cycle. However, if you shoot traditional archery equipment that is made out of natural materials such as wood and horn, sinew, that sort of thing, and you pause in your shot cycle, you are asking for trouble. Now most of the bows I've got are made out of man-made materials, apart from one or two. I've got one horse bow which is a bamboo and sinew laminate, and I've got a longbow which is a softwood. all the rest are laminates of man-made materials, which means you can shoot and you can hold and you can do almost anything you like with them, and they will forgive you for doing it. My longbow will not. If I try and pause with the longbow, it will quickly start to follow the string. Now, the good thing about it, it's an extremely well-made bow. So as soon as I unstring it after the session, it starts to contract again and go back to its original tilted shape. But if I pause too long, it really, really, and you can actually feel it letting down slightly. And that happens to all softwood bows eventually as well, which is why you've got to look after them, you've got to oil them and pet them and squeeze them and love them and hug them, and you will be your friend. But my old longbow, the one that snapped, that was the same, but that was because of age. That was getting really, really old. I mean, it was second hand when I bought it, I believe it was about 10 years old. So when it snapped on my youngster, it was about 25 years old. And it was starting to follow the string after almost every session. So it was getting to the verge where it would need to be retired anyway. But that's the thing you've got to be careful of. I think we'll swap bows now. Right, now, so I'm going to go to my short Turkish. Now, this is a pure fiberglass. It's a modern material bow, which means I can hold it for as long as I like, if I feel so inclined. And it has no effect on the bow itself because it's fiberglass. And it's designed. I mean, it's funny, you can almost feel it complaining, but that's because it's only got a 29 inch draw. And the longer you hold it, it seems to think that you're going to try and pull it even further. And it doesn't like it, but it doesn't do it any harm. I hate it when that happens. So knocks loose. Hate that. Scares the living daylight out of me. Hope I haven't damaged the bow at all. Yeah, loose knock. I'll try that again. Yeah, it's fine. Right, so that can be pulled, and I mean, even you just saw that. I effectively dry fired it. It didn't do it any harm, although I wouldn't recommend doing it again and again and again. Now, this one is a bamboo sinew composite laminate, natural materials. Now this one, if you start to hold and build in a pause, you will actually start to feel the bow complaining. Now I'm not going to do it because I don't want to damage the bow because it's quite short, but it's a 40 pound draw and it flings these arrows away really, really quickly. But if I was to hold it, you can actually feel it starting to loosen off. Right, where are we? See, now the knocks are too tight for this one. Too loose, so it's too tight. So, right, just to demonstrate, I'll hold it for a couple of seconds. Now, I don't know if you'll be able to see anything, but I will be able to feel it. Yeah, you can feel it start. But it's a little bit of an awkward one to demonstrate because it is actually quite a powerful bow. But it flings them away really, really quickly. But I wouldn't dream of holding or building a pause into the shot cycle for that bow, just like I wouldn't with my longbow. However, with this one, which is a Hungarian longbow, supposedly, by a company called Longbow Maker, this is fiberglass. Fiberglass and bamboo. So again, it's a composite. But it's a lot more forgiving, which means you don't have to worry about pausing, about holding. You can just hold it to your heart's content and it'll stay there. And that's the thing you've got to remember. If you're shooting traditional and it's made out of natural materials, don't try and pause. You should be just literally, as I said in the other video, present the bow, find your aim, draw and release. Don't try and do it too quickly, there's no need, but you don't want to be pausing, a specific pause at the end of the draw. So you find the bit, adjust the target, point, draw and release. All your aiming is done with a traditional bow during the presentation cycle, and then you release. But this one being a little bit more forgiving in terms of I can literally hold and then release. Right, so that's enough me rattling on. It's just an excuse to shoot me bows actually. But anyway, hope you found that interesting. Stay safe, keep slinging the sticks, and we shall talk again soon. Now I'm just going to shut up and I'm going to finish shooting these arrows.